would testify, 99% would come in the office and hang out with
him. You said 99% of the inmates would talk to you in the office, correct?
I said 99% of the inmates would talk to
you. But they liked you, right? Because that's why they're there to talk to you.
No, I did not say they liked me. Well, I said they would talk to
you. Okay, well, do you think that 99 out of 100 inmates talk to all the other guards at the other units?
I have no idea what goes on in other units.
Well, you saw Tara O'Hara testify. They don't really want, and they didn't then, really want inmates to just go into the sergeant's office and just have a chat. You knew that, right?
That's because of an incident that happened.
Your incident, right?
No, not my incident.
It happened after you were caught, right? It happened after November 20th of 2017.
Judge, we reject that call and had to speculate he wasn't there after November 20th, 2017.
That's fair. If it's something that was instituted, and I don't know the answer to Mr. Gilmore, I don't know if that was specifically testified to, and I don't want to inject that to the jury, but to Mr. Thompson's point, if it's fair, if it were some policy,
and just back to the rats and snitches thing, you actually specifically said you didn't want rats or snitches because the feds would get tossed, didn't you? Yes or no? Did you say the reason why you didn't want rats or snitches is because you didn't want the feds to get tossed?
Yes.
Okay. Well, and if the beds got tossed, that means contraband might be found in the beds, correct?
Contraband could be found anywhere.
Right, but they can't be found in the beds unless the beds get tossed, correct?
That's the biggest tossed.
Now, during that 2-hour interview with the detectives, did you ever mention somebody by the name of Carl Humshee? And also during that two-hour interview with detectives where you talked specifically about Vera Hudson, you never said anything about your brother giving you money, did you?
No.
And that's because he didn't really actually give you money, did he? At least not the money that you had, correct?
No, I answered the question that he asked.
And you were asked repeatedly about the money, how much you got from Tasha and how you got the money, weren't you?
I was asked about $10,000.
You're asked about the $2,000, correct?
No, he asked me about $1,000.
How much money did you have when you got arrested?
I had $2,000.
So you think that they only were interested in $1,000 and they weren't interested in how you got the total amount of money you have? Is that what you're saying?
The first question he asked me was, she gave you $1,000.
Right, and that's because they asked you that question because Tasha Swain gave you $1,000, right?
No.
She talked with Lacovian about giving you $1,000 the day before. You heard the call, didn't you? You were in the courtroom when we played that call?
I heard the phone call, but I didn't hear I just heard words.
She told Lacovian that she was going to bring you a stack, right?
She was just talking on the phone.
She was talking on the phone. And on the phone, didn't she tell Lacovian Shepherd that she was bringing you a stack?
She
did. Before you were arrested with that $1,000.
She did not say she was bringing. She said, whatever she said the word. She said that she was going to move to her mom's house or whatever she had said. She did not say I was bringing Saunders money. No, whatever you heard on the tape, that's what you heard.
Correct. We didn't just hear the tape though, did we? We also saw Tasha Swain testify, right? Did you see her testify?
Yeah, I saw her testify.
I thought so. You were sitting up there when she testified. And she said when she told the Copian that mom asked for a stack on November 19th, that meant that you had asked her for $1,000. Didn't she not testify to that?
asked her for $1,000.
Well, she said that you asked her for $1,000, but in that jail call that was referenced, let me just take one step back. You know, as a corrections officer, Department of Corrections, that those calls are all recorded, right?
Yes.
So is it surprising to you that inmates don't say over the phone, tell the guard, Steven Saunders, that you're going to give him drugs to bring him to prison? It seems normal that inmates would not say that over the phone, doesn't it?
Yeah, they know phone for that.
Right, so another corrections officer, hopefully one who's not corrupt, would listen to that call and it would initiate some sort of investigation, right?
I guess.
So that's why Lakova and Tasha would use code words when they talk to each other over the phone, right? Any reason why they would, because they know people are listening, right? Correct?
Right.
All right, and let's talk a little about John Small, because that, we heard, is an inmate that was caught with K2 or synthetic marijuana on your unit. You remember that incident, didn't you?
Yes.
And you testified to it earlier, right?
Yes.
So John Small was in the yard at Unit 6 when Brent Robbins, Corrections Officer Robbins, confronted him regarding smoking, right?
Yes.
And isn't it true the only reason why that K2 was found is because a new officer, one who you don't normally work with, was working that day?
Objection, Judge. How do you know that? The only reason it's found because of...
I don't know if that was a reason. They might have no idea how I would know that.
You didn't catch anybody smoking K2 on your unit, did you?
No.
You didn't actually find any K2 on your unit, did you?
No.
The only person that found K2 on your unit while you were there was the new guy, right?
Yes.
Because he wasn't part of the program, right?
No, because he got a phone call.
Did you actually listen to what he was being told on the phone?
No, I didn't listen to what he was told on the phone.
So you don't know if anybody on the phone told him before he left, did you? You didn't hear the words that were coming into Corrections Officer Robbins' ear, did you?
No, I did not.
So Officer Robbins is there, they finish, he comes on shift, he walks outside, he catches John Small smoking, correct?
Correct.
You weren't there when that happened, were you? You were inside the unit.
Yes, I was inside.
And, sir, we learned from you and from Officer Robbins that Robbins brought Small into the unit after he caught him, right?
Yes.
You said in your testimony, you said something about putting him up against the wall. Is that right?
Yes.
You didn't actually effectuate the arrest, did you? But you didn't arrest John Small, did you?
That's why I put the handcuffs on.
Correct.
No.
Officer Robbins did?
No.
Was it the sergeant?
It was one of the GAs that came with the sergeant.
And there's, are you familiar with John Small's discipline report as far as the incident that happened? I think it was May 16th of 2017?
Yes.
Okay. You've gotten that in discovery also, right?
Yes.
And you know there's no report from you in that discipline file, don't you?
Yes.
You didn't write a report.
Yes, I wrote a report.
So where is it?
That's what you have to ask the sergeant.
So you're saying that the sergeant lost your report?
I don't know what the sergeant did with the report, but I know I wrote a report and he gave it to the sergeant.
So you're testifying today that that discipline file, prior to you being arrested, that was created at, in May of 2017, you were arrested in November, that for some reason, Sergeant Robbins would cause that report that you wrote to not be in the file?
I did not say Robbins caused the report.
Or the sergeant, excuse me, it was the sergeant. Is there a reason why the sergeant would cause that to not be in the file?
I have no idea. Once right. I write the report, give it to the sergeant.
Because there's no reason why the sergeant would take your report out of the discipline file, is there?
Judge, how do you know that? How do you know that?
Do you know of any reason why the sergeant would take the report out of that discipline file?
I have no idea.
And Brent Robbins testified that he pretty much did the whole thing with John Small's arrest. Do you remember him saying that?
Yes.
Okay. Is there a reason why he would say that if it wasn't true?
Because it wasn't true.
So you're saying that was not true, that Britt Robbins, or C.O. Robbins, did not do the whole thing with Small's arrest?
He participated in a whole scheme of far as him being arrested, but he did not do the arrest as far as putting the handcuffs on him.
Okay, well, participated. He caught John Small with the K2, correct? Britt Robbins caught John Small with the K2.
Yes, he went out there, he seen him smoking, brought him inside to me.
And he also photographed the K2 itself, didn't he?
I have no idea.
You didn't do it, did you?
I don't know who did it.
So then it's not you, I assume?
No, right. I didn't do it.
Right. And you also didn't bring John Small anywhere after his arrest either, did you? But you didn't transport him anywhere, John Small?
No.
Right. So you really didn't do it.
Yes.
But you said get up against the wall?
I told him to get up against the wall. Robbins went, pat him down, went in his pockets, pulled out the two things that he had. When he pulled them out, I told him, said, watch him, I cleared the table.
That's not documented anywhere, though. That you know of a discipline file, is it? That you did anything.
My report stated that I sat there and I assisted with the arrest of Jimmy Small.
That report that you know is not in the discipline file, correct? You know that it's not in the discipline file based on the survey that you got, correct?
I'm going to object. How would you know what's in the discipline file? You know what's in the file he received, but not the disciplinary file. You received the file from the prosecutor. He has nothing to do with not being there.
Well, I think the issue is whether or not it exists. The reason why it may not exist is up for debate, but I don't think it's disputed, Mr. Thompson, that not that the report wasn't written, but that it currently cannot be accessed. Can't be found.
Well, Judge, he can only be involved in that to the extent documentation is provided to him. I think the proper question is, was a copy of your report provided to you? It wasn't. He doesn't know why.
Understood. Whether or not it did, whatever the reason is that it doesn't exist, I think is an open question. I'm certainly not, and the jury should not infer there's some nefarious intent, but just as an actual matter, unfortunately, the actual document cannot be found and reviewed, at least as we sit here today.
You got discovery, though, regarding John Small being caught, correct?
Yes.
And you've seen, I believe, the sergeant's report. You know that your name is not mentioned one time in the sergeant's report, don't you?
Yes.
And your name is also not mentioned one time in Brent Robbins' report either, is it?
Yes.
So there's no documentation of your involvement either in the officer that searched John Small's report or the sergeant that ultimately completed the investigation report, is there? There's no mention of you whatsoever. If you would like to look at it.
Had that been previously marked?
It had been shown, but I don't think it was previously marked. So for the record, this is marked as S37. And just for the witness, to make it a little easier, the sergeant's report, so